In the previous video, we showed you the various types of stack charts, as well as a bit more information about various types of pie charts. The next type of chart that I want to show you is the doughnut chart. Let's take this existing simple pie chart, using the product sales data that we've seen before, and change it into a doughnut chart by going up to the design ribbon and clicking Change Chart Type, and then selecting Doughnut. If I look here at the data being used by this chart, notice that it's only currently using the 2016 data. If I drag this window over here to also include all the years of sales data, we see that the chart now shows us much more than the previous simple pie chart. Just as pie charts can display individual percentages of the whole, doughnuts can do that as well. Yeah, I know doughnuts have a hole too, but we'll get over that. The big difference between a pie and a doughnut lies in the fact that a pie chart can only show you the percentages of one series or category at a time. As we see here, the doughnut chart can show you all of the series simultaneously. If we look over here at this first chart, we see that we now have 8 rings. Each ring represents a different year of our data. If we hover over one of the rings, we see that this ring displays our 2016 data, this one 2015, etc. Each ring has 3 segments, one for each product category. Now that I have this chart showing you one version of the doughnut, let's look at the data from a different perspective to have it tell us a different story completely. I'll right-click on this chart and select Copy, and then over here out of the way, I'll paste it. Now that I have a new copy to play with, I'll go up here to Design Ribbon and select Switch Row and Column. In our other version of our doughnut, we now have 3 separate rings and each ring has 8 segments. Each ring now represents a product category and each segment now represents a year. Each of these two types of charts has a different focus, so you need to use whichever one focuses on what's important to your audience. This version displays for each year what was the relative contribution of each product category. And this version shows you, for each category, what is each year's relative contribution to the total. Which is right? It depends on whether you're trying to display how the years vary per category or how the categories vary per year. The final set of charts that we're going to discuss in this chapter are the stock charts. On a regular basis, Fido compares the zone's performance in the stock market with that of his competitors. Stock data commonly includes such data as the daily high, the daily low, the daily opening and daily closing prices of the stock. Here in this sheet, we only have the high, the low, and the closing price for the stock. Excel has a very useful set of financial charts that lets us easily chart this data in an industry standardized format. Here we only have a couple of weeks worth of data, but as you'll see with larger timelines, these charts will become more and more useful. The first chart we want to introduce is the simplest one, the high-low close chart. As always, we start by selecting the data that we want included in our chart. I'm going to select all of this data and then click on this new helper here. Charts, more charts, all charts, and stock. Notice that for this first high-low close, Excel shows us a mini version of our chart. If we select any of these others, like open high-low close, volume high-low close, volume open high-low close, we get nothing down here. The fact that only one of these wizards shows us any type of a chart is meant to be a not-so-subtle hint that Excel can read your data and will be able to generate this type of chart, but not any of these. It also gives you a written-out clue as to what you need to do to your underlying data in order to get one of these other chart types to render correctly. After selecting the high-low close, we get our chart. Notice that this chart is called a high-low close chart, and the underlying data is in that exact same order. That's not a coincidence, trust me. Our underlying data must be in the exact same order as the name of the chart in order for the chart to display what we want it to. Now we notice that for each day we have a line which represents the high and low stock price for the day. And then we have this tiny little dot which represents the closing price for that day. If we want to change this little dot to a different icon or make it bigger, we can gracefully right-click on one of them and then format that data series. If I click on this paint can and then click on the marker, then expand out the marker options, we can select automatic or any of these other icons here, as well as adjust the marker size until we're happy with it. Let me select the little up arrow because it's kind of an industry standard and make it big enough to show on my chart. Cool. Now let me add a title, the zone high low close. You can also skip that formatting work if you want to by selecting one of these pre-formatted chart templates up here, but I wanted to show you how to do the more powerful way first. Next, we want to go to this sheet to look at the open high-low close chart. We can see by our data that we have all of the data in the exact order, so let's select it and create it in a slightly different way to show you a different option that you might prefer. Insert. The insert ribbon, this little button here that shows me all the charts, and then I can go to all charts, stock, and then select open, high, low, close. For this chart, we have the concept of an opening price. We still have the vertical line which shows us the high and low price for the day, but we also have this bar which additionally tells us the opening and closing price for the day. Well, that's all well and good, Ken. We have a bar, but is the top of the bar the opening or the closing price? It actually depends on the color of the bar. If the bar is white, then it's called the up bar, meaning that the price rose from the bottom of the bar up to the top of the bar over the course of the day. If the bar is charcoal colored, then it's a down bar, meaning that the price fell on that day from this value at the top to this lower value. If I want to change the colors from white and black to green and red, here's what I need to do. I can right-click on one of the up bars, and we see this text, Format Up Bars. We can then go here and change my color from white to green. Similarly, we can click on the down bar and then Format Down Bars. Now I select red, and we're good to go. Almost. We can delete this legend down here since the chart is already formatted in an industry standard way. This stuff down here is just redundant, and redundancy on our chart violates one of Tufts' rules, and we can't let that happen, can we? Let me give it a title, and we're good to go. The next chart we need to explore is the volume high-low close chart. Here we have a high-low close chart, but we also have the volume of shares that were actually traded added to the chart as well. We also have two different vertical y-axes now. The stock price is now over here on the right, and the number of shares traded is over here on the left vertical axis. The volume is indicated by these solid columns here on the chart. The only thing you have to worry about on this chart is to watch out for situations such as this one here where the volume bar overlaps the high-low close stock data. There are a couple different things you can do. You can change the color of the volume bar to a more transparent color. Let's try this annoying yellow shade. Yeah, that works all right. As an alternative, let me undo this yellow, change it back to blue, close out this formatting box, and let me look at this axis range of numbers here. Let me format that and see how it's automatically set to this value. I can change these and manually override the values to, let's try it here, and see how my stock values went up. I can also go over to this axis and see how it automatically goes from 0 to 3 million. If I change that to 4 million, see how it compresses all of the volume data down? Now the segments of the chart don't overlap anymore. The last chart for this video is the volume open high low close chart. Here we have the data for an entire year in this chart. Also, notice that our underlined data is again in the exact right order to be able to create this chart. Volume, then open, then high, then low, then close. This chart is very similar to the last chart that we showed you, except that it adds the open close bars if you look real close. Now all of this data is very smooshed together since it's an entire year's worth of data. How do we fix that, you ask? Stay tuned to this channel for the next video. Bye-bye for now.